Life Beans and Therapy, the podcast where we spill all the beans. Once again, I've got Jennifer here.
Hi. And
do you want to give a shout out?
My particularly my mother. That's the part. Okay. Cheers.
Anyway, so I had Jennifer here because the topic we will be talking about today is something that I reckon both of us can relate to. And so our topic for today is just about weight loss. And if you've read my blog, you know that I have one of the blog posts I have is called Push Kelly Kelly. Mm-hmm. And I've had people asking me, like, did it really happen? Yes, it did happen. I do have a colleague who went to Ghana, and I asked her, like, what were some of the profound things that she remembers from Ghana? And then she mentioned the abalone, basically where people were calling it obroni. And then she mentioned the Push Kelly Kelly, where people were basically calling it a puskelike. Okay, so I actually do have somebody down there, because I have people who message me and ask me, oh, did you really have, or did you just make up a story? No, I know somebody who actually did go to Ghana and went through those experiences. And the reason why I ended up writing that blog post was because it's very typical for Ghanaians to address you based on your looks or your appearance. Jennifer, is that correct? Based on how you look.
Oh, yeah.
Based on your features. It's very like typical to have them call you Daddy Long Legs because you have long legs.
Or red
because you are ginger. Anyways, it's because you are ginger.
Because you are red.
They call you black because you are black or blacky. They just have this means night. But the funny thing is, it's not derogatory. It's actually a cultural thing, right, Jennifer? Because it's kind of like they're not trying to degrade you. It's just
an identifier.
It's just culturally would use that. So if I don't know your name, I would just feel like I'll call you based on that. Just so you know, I am the person, or you are the person I'm referring to, literally. And after writing that blog post, right, I had like my best friend called me and was like, because he used to call me Bingo because I was fat at that time. And he actually called me. We had a whole discussion because he actually didn't know that, like, when he was, those statements that he used to make used to affect me. But you know, you have to literally, like, you know, man up and then just deal with it because it's coming from all angles.
Is it man up and deal with it? I don't know. It gets to a point where you become not desensitized, but it becomes like, yeah, whatever. You know, like, for me,
I just accept it and just move on.
Yeah, I don't know, like, obolo. You know, somebody sees you, they don't know you from Adam, or you and them are not friends like that, or you're not on that level with them. And they feel they can just refer to you as, oh, but okay. I'm just like, no, please, no. Like, I'm not going to pick an argument with you over that, but yeah.
So, my question is, what was the first time you realized that, I don't say your weight is a problem, but like, what was the first time you... there must be like a first time you realized that your weight was like something that people used to hammer on all the time. Was it like ever a time where you were like, why are these people always constantly talking about my weight?
I don't think so because I've always been fat, or they say fat is a bad word. I've always been big. Mm. Or thick tall, as people like to, you know, politely put it. I've always been thick tall. So, like, from when I was young, I've had people call me, oh, Kesiano, or, you know, the big one, or Obolo. And so, right from, I guess, when I was young, I've had that awareness.
It's been, like, something that has, you've always been aware of.
I don't recall, like, you know, the aha moments, but, hey, I'm fat too. No, it's like, oh, you know, that thing. But when it became annoying was when I was a teenager, because you know, at that point you're just into like, oh, you know, straight your stomach are crying. So even when I start calling you fat, you become super conscious.
I think for me it's very similar to you. I was a big baby as well, and you would have people like And you're not, as I said, you're not trying to be derogatory, but like you go out and people be like, hey, I don't eat other food in the house. Those things, they're trying to make a joke.
What have you been feeding her?
What have you been eating? Or have you been eating some of your brother's food? Stuff like that. And I'm down thinking like, oh, but he actually eats more than me. But I don't understand why. He's so big. Or like you're sitting in the car, like, oh, don't take up all the space. So, like, that's just those like simple things. Oh, and no, you think
you
it's
okay.
You can't
sit in the middle of the seats. You can't sit in the middle. Because you
take up too far. So they'll put you at the edge.
Yes, but then don't
you know, we also went through that. Yeah. And you grow up with these things, and people think it's okay. I'm just trying to say it's not. If you've not been to Ghana before, you're ever planning on going to Ghana, these are things that they consider normal, but it really isn't.
That's wrong.
It is wrong because you grow up thinking, not, I want to say thinking like your weight is a problem. Being overweight can be a problem, but you feel like an ideal size, you have this image in your mind of what an ideal person should look. Because for me, I was literally comparing myself to my siblings. My siblings were really small.
Mm.
And I was the biggest. So in my mind, that weight was the ideal size.
Oh, that's different. You know? So for me, like, because my parents were both, you know, thick, tall. And my siblings, only one of them is slim. I didn't feel out of place. But, you know, when you go to boarding school, you know, like, you see different kinds of people. And then you now start saying, hey, there's Coca-Cola, you know, there's this. And you're just like, maybe if my stomach was flatter, it would be nice. And so you start doing the whole, I don't eat for 1 week. And then, you know, it's not working for you because your body is not wired like that at that particular time. So.
I think that for me it was different because way before I went to, or even went to secondary school, and the reason I'm saying that is because I think the eureka moment from the most profound moment for me was when, just to be fair, I was part of the cultural dancing team. Yeah, I used to do cultural dancing. And that year, they said, you can't dance because you are too fat.
Wow.
No, literally. That was a time, like, thinking about it now, I think that was the day when my weight became, like, a focus for me of something like I need to deal with.
Mm.
And so I was so determined to dance that year, I began to starve myself.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and I did dance that year. I was still overweight, but every time, like, it's like you are conscious of what you're doing. And I think that was the day from that time I realized that my weight is a problem. That was maybe before I even went to high school. So that was the day I realized my problem. And then I began to focus on my weight. But I think for me, my journey, funny enough, was with Oprah. Because at that time, Oprah was also dealing with, like, her weight issues. And she was somebody I looked up to. And so I was watching her shows.
As an Oprah went.
Yeah, so, like, I was watching her shows and I was listening to, like, all her dieting tips. Yada, yada, yada. And I went to secondary school and I became really, really small. And that's when I actually shut up. Like,
Lord, where shall I?
No, but that was when I became this tall. But the thing is, it was unhealthy because I was starving myself to the point where I would even forget to eat on certain days. And I'll go to bed and I'll be like, oh my gosh, I haven't eaten today. And my body clock just shut down. Like, even to go to the point where my body, like, you know how your body is supposed to tell you when you're hungry? It wasn't working. I'll go through an entire day, forget I haven't eaten anything, and then go to bed and, oh God, I haven't eaten anything. I just go and have, like, maybe a cup of water or some juice and go to bed. But then that was unhealthy weight loss for me. And those things don't last. I don't know about you, but I realized from experience that all these diets work for a certain amount of time and then they stop working.
Sure.
You know?
But you know it's really funny that you said you did the whole starving thing. So for me, I feel like I've been active throughout my childhood. So I did basketball, at one point I was doing handball, like I was doing all these sports, I was doing shot put, I was active, I was even running like cross country when we were doing in school. And so for me, like when I was in, you know, secondary school is where you put your mind, okay, when I get to secondary school, then I'll lose weight. And you get to secondary school, you do all these activities, you lose weight. For me, I'll lose weight, but I'd always hit like a threshold and not go beyond that. And my arms are structurally, and my arms are bigger than my frame. And so even if I lose weight, same crap, my arms will still be big. So I guess that one too was very, for me, made me conscious. And so whenever I've tried to do these fat things, so I've done this, 7 day, that 10 day green fast.
A juice fast.
I did a green one. Fast. Mm. So I blend kale. I hate kale. So I blend spinach with like apple or grapes, and then with that you only have to snack on apple and peanut butter. And I did that for 10 days, And look, it works. So your stomach will be flat within that 10 days, guaranteed. But it's just because
but then you begin to gain, and the funny thing is you actually become bigger than you actually were before you even started. It's like a never-ending cycle. I didn't
have that issue of becoming bigger than I was. It's just it's not sustainable. You know, it's not sustainable because afterwards you just have to ask yourself, can you eat like that? Like just drink green blended vegetables? And the answer is no. So I don't know. Me, I've put in my mind that Lord, your will be done. Because I will eat healthy, you know. I eat as much as I can healthy, and now I don't do any diet. I can't come and kill myself because of this thing. You know, shout out to Bay, doesn't give me pressure, you know, whatever.
And I think for me, the time I realized that this whole weight loss thing was a facade was when, you know, I said I followed Oprah for a long time, and then she began to gain weight again. And I'm like, if Madam Oprah with all her money and all her shirts and stuff is even gaining again, then who am I?
I'm myself.
Like, who am I? Like, to even, and honestly speaking, mine was my journey was weird. Like, I lost so much weight in secondary school, even to the point where my parents became concerned because people. It's just, you see, like, people were on me about my size, and I lost so much weight, and they were on me again. Like, why are you so small? Going to my parents, asking my parents, is he sick? Like, you can't please people.
It's not we judge health based on appearance, which is
why is he so small? Is he sick? What's wrong with him? Then my parents come to me and like, you must. It got so bad that
you must eat.
My dad would literally bring food to my room and be like, eat. And it's like, hey. It's not like he's instructing you to eat. You're making me look bad. My mom becomes concerned because, like, are you sick? And people ask me, are you going to depression? I'm like, no, I'm just dieting. Like, I'm trying to lose weight.
They were
trying to make you eat. They were forcing me to point to, like, they must. And my brother would be asking, has he eaten today? We bring the food to my room. He must eat this. I'm not going. And I was like, no, I was being forced to eat. You know? But then I began to understand that, you know, starving yourself is not sustainable. You know? And so I began eating again, and I began to gain weight again. And I was even bigger than I was before. But then I got introduced to working out. You know, that was when I think my working out lifestyle started, in secondary school. So I've been working out for a number of years, but I wasn't really seeing any changes because you know how Ghana is, like, there's really no information. You just go to the gym and do what you want. So I was working out, like, guys, I was working out. I was like killing myself. That was the same size. There was no change, you know. But I was committed to this, and I began to do my research into it as well. And now I found what works for me. I'm not going to push some of these formula on people, but now I found what works for me. But this is what I would say, that it was when I realized that weight loss is not necessarily the goal. Staying healthy is the goal, was when my life changed.
Absolutely.
So it was a mindset change that basically, I began to lose weight, honestly, when I changed my mindset. So the mindset was health versus weight loss. Weight loss is like an add-on to the healthy lifestyle. So if I'm healthy, I'm eating the right things, I'm exercising, and I am a size 10, so be it, you know? But I am happy or comfortable, assured in the fact that I'm healthy, you know? And then to put the tickets on the biblical angle, you know, like, your body is the temple of God.
Come on.
Right? And God put you on this earth for a particular purpose. And he needs your body to do certain things. And so the body is not for you. If somebody has given you something to take, you must take care of it.
Yeah.
You know, so with that understanding, I realize that it goes beyond me and my personal, like, wants and desires to understanding that I have something valuable I need to take care of. And I'll go back to Oprah, because we had this challenge. She was like, why must you finish an entire bar of chocolate when there's always tomorrow? Like, you forget that there's always tomorrow. Like, you know, like, that's one of the things that really changed my life. Like, when she said, look, why do you must you finish this entire bar of chocolate? Like, honestly speaking, what's the reason? There's actually no reason. You don't understand what I'm saying. There's actually no reason. There's always tomorrow. So I had to discipline myself. But I'm not saying that was an easy thing. But I literally had to discipline myself to maybe eat around four, but maybe I started leaving two. Then I'll leave four. But then I realized I can eat like four bars and I'm okay.
But you know what? At least you could identify what makes you fat. So, for instance, yours was eating the chocolate or sweet.
Dessert was my thing. I'm not really
for
a fan
me,
of food.
I don't have anything like, you know, like how many times do I eat in a day? So, I had to come to the terms with the fact that maybe biologically, but people like to say big bones.
Yeah, big
I don't know how that works, to be honest. And I don't like to say I'm big bone. I'm just fat or I'm big. Like, I can't come and kill myself. I'm fat. So I think for me, when I came to that realization that Charlie, this is you, I now, like you're saying, started focusing on being else. So I've done the whole gym because I've been active, you know, throughout my life. Just not like when I started working, you know, I don't have time. So like what I haven't done is figured out how to include workouts into my day.
Your work life.
Especially now that we're in lockdown, dear Charlie, or even, you know, lockdown really, but now that we're working from home and everything, I'm not the kind of person, and I guess it's a discipline thing, to wake up at 4 a.m. I go to bed God knows what time. Wake up at 4 a.m. and do a workout and then start my day. And at the end of the day too, I'm too tired to do it. So for me, that's the thing. So the focus for me now is eat healthy. So I do the things I can do. So I, for instance, I'll go for a walk in the middle of the day if I feel like I've been sitting down for too long. Or, and I'll just walk. And it doesn't have to be like, well, I have to walk 30 minutes. I just do walks. So it could be 15 minutes, it could be 30, it could be an hour. As long as I put some activity into my day. And then in terms of eating as well, and this is something I picked from you, during the week, so Monday to Friday evening, I will eat healthy. Doesn't mean I'm not eating carbs, you know, I'm not eating jollof, whatever. I'm just very conscious
of
the amount
I eat. Your body. Yeah.
So if I'm eating jollof or whatever, I'm conscious of how much of that I'm eating. And so I'll tend to focus on maybe proteins, vegetables, things like that. Yogurt, granola, I'll eat that sort of thing. So trying to eat healthy during the week. And on Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Charlie, life must go on. Yeah, I eat what I want to eat. And then we're back on the grind on Monday to Friday. And for me, as long as that's making me feel healthy within my body, because when you're unhealthy, you can't feel it.
Yes, you can.
You know, as long
because
as
we literally just started like eating like extra, like, we've gone an extra mile to even change like, the kind of carbohydrates.
Absolutely.
And you can feel it in your body, like you feel lighter. Even if when you use the bathroom, you can tell that your body's is but you know, like your body, you know, like
you know
feel
that
you're
doing
feel
something.
It, you feel different. Literally.
And it's like kind of like when you eat. Imagine eating like a whole box of pizza. It's nice, though, but at the end of the day, you feel some way, you know.
And when you eat healthy too, and you put something that is not good in your body, your body tells you that this is not good for you because you immediately begin
I'm
to feel.
So why is it not? Like I'm so sorry.
You, I'm not good. But you immediately see the difference.
Absolutely.
So guys, like I'm not attacking anybody. All I'm saying is, from my personal experience, weight, like addressing people's weight is a problem. If you're a Ghanaian or
it's not your place to do
it's
it.
Not your, the thing is, we know. We know. We don't need you to remind us. We know. We know, like, honestly, because I mean for me, like when I go to the store, because when I go shopping with my brother and he gets things that he likes and I don't, it upsets me. It's not eating. Then you will come and point it out. Like, I know.
Oh, yeah, I used to have that issue.
You know, I know. I know.
You don't find your clothes.
You don't find your size, or the things you like don't fit you,
or
the things that don't fit you, you don't like them.
You go to shop and
you ask
them, oh, do you do plus size clothing?
You don't have any
size. Oh, you have to go online. You know, and that's annoying. Now that I'm older, it doesn't worry me. So I'll go to the shop, and the first thing, it's not wasting my time. I'm going to ask you, do you stock plus size and shop? Then, if no, I know where to walk. You know, but if yes, then fine. But when I was younger, that was a bit much for me because you go to a shop, your cousins are getting things, and you are just there. They are looking for some adult dress for you because the children things don't fit you. You know,
and there's no color you like, so things you like don't fit you. The things that fit you, you don't like them. So guys, we know that. No, messing our weight is a problem. We know that we are the biggest person in the room. We don't need you to remind us.
It's not the biggest,
but yeah, but that's the thing. If you are a particular size, look, this basic thing, if there's something about you you don't like, change it. Literally. So if you're a particular size you don't like, just work on your eating. And I always say, the focus is not weight loss, but it's being healthy.
If you're a particular size you don't like, I think the starting point is
your mindset.
Your mindset. Being real with yourself that this is the size I'm at. You cannot kill yourself. accept it, not in the sense that accept maybe if you're doing something wrong, you know, like health, eating unhealthy, whatever. Accept that this is you. I think if you start from that point, then you can say, okay, maybe now let me try and eat healthier. Let me do things that will make me healthier. Not to lose weight, but do things that will make me healthier.
Yeah.
And then eventually, if you know, if you start losing weight,
good.
Fine. If not, like some of us, me, I'm not shy to say I'm a size 18. You know, like, I can't come and kill myself. I still look what... I can't come and kill myself.
Mm.
But I know I eat healthy. I do things. Whether or not I lose weight, though, I don't even, like, I don't lose weight, though. At the end of the day, like, I sleep, you know, I move. What can I do again? Lipo. I've considered lipo, actually.
I have.
But I'm just like, na me kona man baby. For the non-English.
Yeah, she's a prayer.
If I go
ahead. Pray yourself.
Look, that's some prayers you're praying to God. Oh God, this life I'm going to do. Let me come back safe. If I was God in heaven, I'd look down at you and be like, ah, why? You know, so me, like, those are the sorts of things. I think I've come to the place now, and it's not like an overnight thing.
Mm-hmm.
It's with time, and I guess with age as well. I don't want to say maturity, because we all know age does not equal maturity.
Just letting me know you're mature.
So with time, I've come to the point of acceptance that, oh, thank you. I've come to the point of acceptance that this is me, you know, this is me, and to an extent there's a biological aspect to it. And you also have to understand your biology, because somebody naturally has a small frame. And so if you see that girl that ODD 1,000 times or cry, they don't
that even talk. Brings me to, like, because the moment the day I put out the post about the Push Kelly Kelly post, I had, well, she said, like I mentioned, they mean, and Abby messaged me, and she was like, such a great read, love it. But if I haven't read my blog, yeah, just say you're a person. Anyways, it says, I got called a brony because I have a typical white woman's flat ass. And I used to have a really high self-esteem when I thought I had a typical African woman Coca-Cola shape. Now I'm just overly conscious of it. It affects the clothes I choose to wear. These labels leave an unconscious mental imprint. And so it was interesting how I always felt like weight gain was a problem, but I had people like write back to me after the blog post went out and talked about how, like, for people who are small as well, weight gain is also a problem for them. People constantly referring to them as small and small and small leaves that imprint in their minds. And she's starting to point to it now when she's wearing clothes, she's conscious of how her backside looks because they've called her flat ass with bony buttocks. Bony buttocks for the longest time. So there's certain things that she won't wear. There's some people who won't wear jeans because they say their buttocks is flat.
Oh, really?
So they only wear dresses. Like, I don't see certain people like that. They wouldn't wear jeans.
That's
but they've been cut patterns their whole life.
That's it. I've actually had a friend. This was while I was in school, but back ago. Who, she's very slim, very very slim. Who said, "Hey, if I had your body, Charlie, to each his own."
Yeah, and you are there thinking, if I had your body, she's saying, like, in life,
you have to just, you know, appreciate this is you at this particular time, and just be a better version of you. If that means eating healthy, eat healthy. If that means incorporating some form of exercise or activity, movement into your daily routines, include that. And if the result of that is weight loss, great. If the result of that is that you stay the same, great. Because at the end of the day, you should strive for health and not necessarily a particular appearance, unless it's giving you emotional stress, in which case it's between you and your God. What you do, whether you do lipo or tummy tuck or whatever, God bless you. When you come back, we'll see.
I'm trying to actually find, like, another because Roxanne as well said, this is interesting, this is about the Push Kelly Kelly blog post, and she said a lot of skinny people face similar issues too, except that sometimes it's even more indirect, you know. So it was interesting to have, like, small people, like, comment on the blog post and talk about how they also go through the same thing. And I'm the sad thing is I'm also guilty of constantly calling people small, or it's interesting how I'm upset that people call me big, but I'm here thinking, yeah, but
you don't expect them to take offense.
I didn't actually think that it was a problem. Then that could also mean that people actually call us that way, but they don't necessarily expect that it's a problem for us. They think that I just make a conversation or just referring.
But has nobody ever seen you and said, "Hey, who's small?"
Like, what is it like? What can you imagine what are some of the things that they call you? They call me Obolotufe, Oboshi.
Oh, Oboshi.
Oh, what? Oluftubo. Have you heard Oluftubo before?
Oluftubo. I don't know what they call me.
Oh, like, just a lot. At some point, you just zone out.
Yeah, for me, it's
Fatibom.
We've been called that.
Oh my god, Fatibom. Like, I remember there was one time when, like, the PE teacher, the PE teacher actually let me, like, he let the everybody went back to their classroom. And I mean, I saw on the basketball doing push ups because he said I'm fat. And
I have an idea of who the teacher is.
Yeah, anyways, where it was, like, guys, if you're listening to me, it's not right to
address
people by their weight. And I'm saying Ghanaian because I'm Ghanaian, I'm not Nigerian, so I don't know what the Nigerian scope is like. But in Ghana, it's normal. So if you're going to Ghana, first things first, be aware of the fact that they'll call you Obroni.
And don't take offense.
They'll call you Obroni, or they'll call you Tola, or Enimre,
or Bright,
or Red, or stuff like that. And it's not personal, like it's just a cultural thing to refer to you based on your looks or your appearance, and there's nothing personal. But being on the receiving end, please don't. Like, if I'm taller, you know, so when I'm sitting in a church and I'm hanging like a
butterfly. And do tall people take offense if they call you taller?
Yeah, because
me, I'll still call them that. I'm sorry.
I think it depends on how it's said. Like, depends on how it's said, literally.
So,
for example, when you're in class and then your assistant wants to tell you, oh, go back, you taller, you come sit in front. And those things, it's painful. I think those things are, you never had that before.
I'm sorry, because I always used to sit at the back, right?
Hey,
used to be
because my eyes were bad. I want to sit in front and tell you, go back, you are tall, go back.
No, why do you want to sit in front?
I can't see. I can't see. But I can't see.
In that, I'm so sorry. I know we are supposed to give a message, but in that circumstance, sit tall. I'm going to sit at the back because people need to see the board. Okay, they should say me. Go and sit at the back because
I have a name.
Also, it's the name that bothers you.
Anyways, guys, look. These are my final words to you. If you're a particular weight you don't like, first of all, it's a mindset thing. It's not weight loss, it's healthy living. You must live healthy so you can live long enough for God to use you for His purpose.
Mm-hmm.
Healthy living comes with a particular lifestyle. With that lifestyle change, sometimes comes with weight loss, which is a plus. If it doesn't come with weight loss and you're a particular size, just love yourself. I think the most is just being comfortable in your own skin. Because confidence goes along, it shows in every aspect of your life. Like even the way you talk, the way you dress, it shows. Confidence is, oh, that's sexy. Confidence is...
Please, are we supposed to do gospel on this channel?
Yeah, why not?
So then the second thing that I say
is... Confidence is... It's attractive.
Yes.
I think that's the word. Confidence is attractive. And I think your demeanor will determine the kind of people that you attract to yourself as well. And how you carry yourself will determine how people refer to you and how people deal with you as well. And there's some big people in this world about confidence in whom they are as well. And then also when they come, lifestyle changes, I think also affects every area of your life in terms of like how you perceive work, like your punctuality to work. It affects every other area of your life. As well. Do you have any closing words, Jennifer?
So it's here for Ghana for. Sorry. This is for everyone who is managing as well. My final words are to fat people. Sorry, if you're offended that you are fat. Me, I'm fat and I can say fat people. Maybe I can't say fat people. Big people, right? Enjoy yourself. Like live your life, right? There's no ideal weight. An ideal weight is somebody's construct. There is, you know, be healthy, and it's a personal thing. And look nice, please. Don't say my stomach is flat, is not flat, I can't wear shoe or stomach. Please wear shoe or stomach. And I'm a tongue speaking Christian, if that means anything. But dress, please. Look nice. Look in the mirror, look at yourself. And appreciate what God has given you or what you look like, and then move from there. So don't just say, oh, me every day I'm fat. Because if you do that every day, you'll be complaining. and you end up not enjoying or living a quality life. And that, like you were saying, it impacts every single thing you do, and it will impact how other people see you. If you see yourself as, oh, I'm nowhere, it impacts your self-esteem even. And that also, you know, whatever. So basically, my final words are, live it up.
My final words to you would be, love yourself enough to take care of yourself. We need you, the entirety of you in this world.
Oh, you sound deeper than I do.
In this world, to make it meaningful. Also, don't forget that you were fearfully and wonderfully made.
Please, can I change my final
words? Why are you interrupting me?
My final words.
And then I'll go.
Jesus
again.
Loves you regardless of your size. Thank you.
Okay, so I'll take it again. My final words would be, love yourself enough to take care of yourself. We need you, the entirety of you in this world, to make it meaningful. Also, don't forget that you are fearfully and wonderfully made. It doesn't end there. God breathed himself into you. He gave you a part of himself. So own it. So Charlie, until the cock crows again, keep eating your kale away against your pure water, the sun, sunshine, and sunflowers. To catch you same time. Whenever I put up another podcast.
Wanda.
Yeah, this is Chef Lee. I didn't even introduce myself. This is Chef Lee. You're listening to Life Is in Therapy. Bye.
You look at you looking so succulent.
Thanks for watching this video. But don't forget to subscribe to this channel for regular updates. Yeah. Oh, and we are socializing on Instagram and Facebook at Life Beans and Therapy. Bum.